The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Yatba'u al-mayyita thalatha." The deceased is followed to his or her grave by three things: ahluhu, wa maluhu, wa amaluhu. His family, his wealth, and his deeds. فَيَرْجِعُ أَهْلُهُ وَمَالُهُ وَيَبْقَى عَمَلُهُ. So his family and his wealth turn back from the grave and they go home. And his only companion that remains with him in his new home from now on is his collection of deeds. And we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the Day of Judgment what? يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ. The day that wealth and children are no longer of any benefit. From this point onwards, deeds are going to be your comfort and they're going to be your currency.
A person who goes down into their grave after the soul has gone and they are in their grave, imagine what will be the condition of an individual there. We believe that there is something known as dhaghtatul qabr. You know, the grave being made narrow. How is it going to be made narrow? Allah knows, but we believe it. It's going to happen because it's there. The Prophet ﷺ explained it to us. That, you know, tightening or the narrowing of that grave, what will happen? And how the person will be tested so much and how they will be questioned in that grave. It's the truth. The angels will come and they will seat the individual. How it will happen, Allah knows best. But the questions are going to be asked by the angels. Who is your Rabb? Who is your Nabi? What is your Deen? And so on. And it's no good for us to say, well, I know the answers every day in the morning. I used to say it 20 times. That's not good enough. If you were following, you will be able to answer. And if you are not following, you won't be able to answer.
And the Prophet ﷺ once asked the companions, do you know what Allah meant when he said, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ? That those who turn away from my remembrance will have a constricted life. وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى? And will be raised up on the Day of Judgment blind. Now, that constricted life is certainly across all realms. But here the Prophet ﷺ said, when they go to their grave, يُسَلَّطَ عَلَيْهِ تِسْعَةٌ وَتِسْعُونَ تِنِّينَ. Allah places 99 dragons over that person. And the Prophet ﷺ went on to describe that every one of those dragons is like 70 serpents with 7 heads, stinging him and maiming him until the Day of Judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us.
How are you going to prepare for the Akhirah? My brothers and sisters, it's an important message. The preparation for the life after death is the most important thing that I need to prepare for. You know, we will all invest our wealth because we want, mashallah, high-rise building and a little apartment. We will go out and get loans, inshallah, hope they are halal, inshallah. But from wherever we get some loans and we want to, pay back over time because I need to own the house. Do you know what's happening? And I have seen this in a lot of cases of people who've passed away. They took out loans, they wanted big apartments or homes for their families and themselves. Before they could pay back the loan, they were already in need of a palace in the hereafter because they died.
The Prophet ﷺ said that when the believer is placed into their grave and they hear the final footsteps of their family leaving, the punishment comes. And as the punishment comes from above, your prayer stands up and it puts its hand up and says, مَا قِبَلِي مَدْخَلٍ. You will not pass through me. So the prayer guards your head. And then the punishment comes to you from your right side. And the Prophet ﷺ said, your siyam, your fasting rises and stands guard and says, مَا قِبَلِي مَدْخَلٍ. You will not pass through me. And then to his left, his zakah stands and says, مَا قِبَلِي مَدْخَلٍ. You will not pass through me. And then at his feet, his sadaqah and sila, his goodness towards his family and then his community, his voluntary charity, his truthfulness, his honesty, all of those things stand guard at the bottom and say, مَا قِبَلِي مَدْخَلٍ. You will not pass through me. And then it's said to him, sit up. And he sits up. The Prophet ﷺ said that the sun is made to appear to him as if it's about to set. Yani it's almost Maghrib. It's about to be Maghrib. So the believer is accustomed to what? You're accustomed to salah. You're accustomed to prayer. And if you wake up at an odd time, sort of disoriented, the first thing you worry about is, did I miss my prayer? So this person says, let me pray. And the angels say, you'll get to that, but first you have to answer our questions. Man Rabbuk? Who is your Lord? Ma Deenuk? What is your religion? Man Nabiyuk? Who is your Prophet? Now the only way you're going to be able to answer who your Lord is if you used to worship Him. And the only way you're going to be able to answer what your religion is if you actually used to practice it. And the only way you're going to be able to answer who your Prophet is, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is if you used to actually follow him. And if you answer right, a voice cries out from the heavens and says, Sadaqa abdi, my slave has spoken the truth. And subhanAllah, in one hadith, the Prophet said that those two angels that were first frightening, they say to you after you answer the questions correctly, كُنَّا نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ تَقُولُ هَذَا. You know, we knew you were going to say that. We knew you were going to answer these questions right. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then calls out, supply him with the furnishings from Jannah. Clothe him from the clothes of paradise. Open for him a gate to paradise so that some of its fragrance comes to him in his grave. And then his grave is expanded for him as far as his eye can see. And then at that point, you are laying in the clothes of Jannah with a window to Jannah. And everything starts to feel like Jannah, starts to feel like paradise. This visitor comes to you, and this visitor has this beautiful face, has these fine clothes, and has this pleasant scent. And he says to you, أَبْشِرْ بِالَّذِي يَسُرُّكْ هَذَا يَوْمُكَ الَّذِي كُنْتَ تُوعَدْ. Glad tidings of that which will bring you happiness. This is your day which you were promised. And so the deceased says, Man ant, who are you? فَوَجْهُكَ الْوَجْ يَجِئُ بِالْخَيْرِ. That face of yours is only going to be a face that brings good news. And that person responds to you and says, أَنَا عَمَلُكَ الصَّالِحِ. I am your good deeds. Now subhanAllah, imagine what your good deeds look like all in one person. The beauty of that, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, if you actually used to act upon that guidance from Allah, what does your Quran, your prayer, your fasting, your charity all look like in the form of one person saying to you, I am your good deeds and I'm here to give you good news.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Man thalladhi yuqridu Allah qardan hasana fayudha'ifahu lah. Allahu Akbar. Who is there who is going to give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that that loan would be multiplied so many fold? Subhanallah. Are you ready to do for Allah? Spend your time for Allah. Spend your energy for Allah. Abstain from sin for the sake of Allah. You will find its reward multiplied. When you need your palace in the akhirah, it will be there. You will already be given glad tidings of it from the moment the angels come to take your soul away.
In any case, everything you experience now is part of the lead up to the last day. And the Prophet ﷺ said, when a person dies, he's shown his eventual place morning and evening. And so if he's amongst the inhabitants of paradise, he has this window to his place in paradise. And he's constantly told, this is where you're headed to. This is where you're going. And if he's amongst the people of the fire, may Allah protect us, he's shown his place in the fire and is told, this is where you're going. And no matter what his situation is, he's shown one more place. And he looks at this place and is told, هَذَا مَقْعَدُكَ الَّذِي تُبْعَثُ إِلَيْهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. This is the place that you're going to be sent to on the Day of Judgment.
Ask Allah to grant us goodness. People have died. And people who did not believe that there was a hereafter are already in the hereafter. What fools, subhanAllah. People who did not believe in the hereafter are already in the hereafter. They've gone. Where are we going? Prepare for the grave. People will come, they'll bury you, they'll carry you. Like I always say, there will come a day when the phones will be ringing, the messages will be flying, people will be tweeting and WhatsApping, and people will be putting posters and statuses and so on regarding your death. The day is coming. The day is definitely coming. People will phone. How many times have you received a phone call and a message? Someone you knew, close to you, they say, Inna lillahi, the person's gone. Ah, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. How? What happened? Sometimes we are shocked. Shocked? Well, you know what? The bigger shock will be if you were just taken without preparation. That's a bigger shock. May Allah help us. Because when I go, I'm all alone.
So for the believer who has his deeds with him as provision, he's got his clothes from paradise. You've got your window to paradise. When he sees his place on the Day of Judgment, he's not running away from it. In fact, he's saying, Rabbi aqim as-sa'a, Rabbi aqim as-sa'a, Rabbi aqim as-sa'a. My Lord, establish the hour. My Lord, establish the hour. My Lord, establish the
hour.